Good day again, peoples. We are gathered here today to join ourselves in holy beer trimony. Today we will be sampling the White Bark Unfiltered Wheat Ale from the Driftwood Brewery, craft brewed in Victoria, BC.
With hints of coriander and orange peel.
Oh, really?
That's what it says.
You are correct. Subtle malt allows the floral essence of coriander, curacao, orange peel, and orange peel from the West Indies to balance the profile of distinguished ale.
I don't know what I think about floral beer, but we'll see how this...
Well, I mean, we tried that blackcurrant one. Which we didn't film, but we will.
And that was good.
It has 5% alcohol. I have no idea what the IBU... They have this thing called an IBU, which is the International Bitterness Unit. So it'll, like, you know, you've had beers that'll go like...
Yeah.
And it's, like, nasty.
Smell the cork.
Yep. It's a weird thing I do. We have... Oh, it's got some floral stuff to it.
And very yeasty.
Yes. Oh, actually, damn it. There's... Should have rolled the bottle. There's, it's unfiltered, so all the yeast settles to the bottom there. I should have rolled the bottle, but,
Damn unprofessional.
I know. So it's gonna be a mic clatter.
Well, what you really should do is shake it, then.
Fuck you.
That there's gonna have a big head.
So let's sit here and talk about it for a while. There you see it's
very pretty.
It's a bit cloudy. You know, wave the dark bottle behind the beer, you get a little bit of an idea. It does have kind of a like a lemonade kind of a look to it almost.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely unfiltered.
It has that yeasty bready kind of.
Smells good.
Yep, it smells like. That last bit I put in the glass is going to be really yeastified. Now it says that it's 5% alcohol, but they put yeast in the bottle, so I'm going to go ahead and guess that it's gone up at least another percent.
It's a very light aftertaste.
Yeah. That pretty much what it said on the bottle, it delivers for me. It does have, you get some fruit, and there's definitely... Some floralness.
I don't get any coriander, but I'm getting a little touch of the orange in there.
Yeah.
Especially when you kind of smell it a little bit while you're drinking.
Yeah. It's got kind of like somebody put a lot of fruit in some bread dough.
That is a truly unique beer.
Yeah.
I have to say.
I wonder if we'll have to try and sample some more wheat beers or wheat ale. I'm just doing the extra H in there for all the Family Guy fans. Not that I enjoy Family Guy. I'm just trying to get ratings. Sorry. I'm sorry.
When you tag it, you have to put Family Guy.
I will.
So, it says... Do you say where it's brewed already?
Victoria, BC at the Driftwood Brewery.
Mm-hmm.
Feel free to send us more to sample. I'm not... You know, I'll take bribes. Yeah, it's got... I don't know about you, but like the top of the tongue gets all the flavor. I get like a lot of sweetness up front and in the back, and in the middle I get kind of the yeast kind of bread kind of thing going on in there.
I don't know how to explain that.
Yeah, it's really, it's odd. It's like last time we did the box is still over there, the Nature organic black stout, that was like... Like, it would run over your tongue and it would be gone. This stuff will run over your tongue and then kind of go, what do you think about that? And then it leaves.
It sort of has a multi-layer flavor to it. But it's not super strong. Like, it's light, but still definitely has a flavor to it.
Yeah. Yeah, this would qualify. This, I think I would buy this again just to have around. I'm more of the... mind that I will have a beer and I will have a beer to enjoy it. I don't generally drink with meals. Sometimes when I'm out at the bar and have some pub food, that's kind of what pub food is for. But I don't like to, like when I'm eating food, I like to have food and I'll have like, you know, I might have a soft drink, but usually just water. And so I can taste my food and enjoy my food. You know, and I don't have something else trying to crowd in where the food was. But
keep in mind, this man is kind of weird when it comes to flavors.
I am strange. But this I would buy again because I would, you know, I could see myself enjoying one of these just on its own.
Mm-hmm.
And I usually don't drink more than one, sometimes two in a night. And then usually I don't drink for another 3 or 4 days. Occasionally I'll go on a bender and have like one every night for like 2 weeks. In my mind, getting drunk is, like, you can get drunk off beer, but I mean, spirits get you drunk faster, so.
If that's your goal, then.
You get more for, it's one of those more for less kind of deals, right? So, that's what, I don't generally drink beer and get drunk. Maybe if I haven't had anything to eat. Yeah, I still don't know how really to describe it. It's got, I am starting to get more of that coriander now. The more I have of it, the more it kind of, you get past the, like all the sweet, all the higher notes, all the floral and the orange peel, that starts to go away and you start to get more of the,
actually,
the earthy kind of.
I definitely am getting that after the first few.
Mm-hmm.
It's more of the lingering flavor. And the yeast as well.
Yeah.
I really like it. That's good.
Yeah. So what do you give that a 10?
I'm not generally a light beer fan, but for a light beer, I'd give that probably an 8.
An 8?
Yeah, solid.
I would say 8 as well.
Yeah.
That would, I would not hesitate to pick that up again. Do enjoy it. I don't know if you can have a very good view of that. I'm really not sure where my depth of field is at this point.
Kitty cat wants some too.
Well, pick the cat up. Everybody likes to see the cat. Oh, she's freaking out. No, dude. Hit her with my foot.
Cats of doom.
You hold up the one behind you. People like him too. Kitty is here to help us engage in flavor.
Giant kitty. The giant kitty eats a little kitty.
Okay. Ow, 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 ow. She got really pokey feet.
So yeah, I recommend that one. White bark.
The white bark wheat ale from Driftwood Breweries. Contains water, barley malt, and wheat, hops, yeast, orange peel, and coriander. Has a, I don't know, once again, not sure where my depth of focus or field is here, but they have symbols and, like, it's basically a symbolic ingredients list right here on the side, which is kind of cool. So, Driftwood Brewery in Victoria, BC, well done. That's all we have to say for today for the Headhunting Episode 3. Unless you have anything to add?
Nope. Good beer. Tried it.
Peace to love in the death metal.